the first. It's Lydia, and I'm back with another project for you. This project is still life. So for this one, I'm going to be using some pre-cuts that I have. So I have a bottle. I have a pitcher, a water pitcher or juice, whatever you want to put inside, whatever you can imagine to put inside. And I have a pumpkin because it is fall, so I wanted to add something that is about fall. And I have apple. I have three glasses actually. And I have some oranges here and some fruits. So I'm gonna go ahead and paint these first because I want them to dry. I can keep them like this. And then I'm gonna do my background. For my background, I'm using a canvas board. And I'm using acrylic paints, of course. So let's do that. I'm gonna use a little brush. And since I have so many details, I'm gonna be using different colors. So here, first I'm painting my bottle. I'm gonna try to put a little bit of shadows on each side. So let's see. Just a little shadows. So one side is darker, one is lighter. Okay, so that's my bottle. I'm gonna move to glasses. My glasses, I can do them. I'm gonna do light purple. So you see, I'm doing the bottom dark, and I'm getting up to the top and using more the edge of the brush, which has more water on it. Okay. So I have bottle painted and I have glasses. And I'm gonna do water pitcher now. Let's make a fun color. Actually, I wanna make this. I'm gonna mix these two colors. So I'm gonna mix this pinkish. With dark purple. So I'm gonna use lighter purple. And water pitchers can be really fun. Can come in different colors, so I'm gonna put some colors on mine, okay? So I'm adding some blue. And then I can actually add some details. I can do some dots. A nice, let's say, ceramic water pitcher. Okay. I'm gonna add some on top too. So I'm making my own designs. And you can do that as well. For your glasses, for the water pitcher, for the bottle, whatever you have. Pumpkin, apple, and let's say oranges, I'm gonna paint in their real colors. So I'm gonna do paint pumpkin, orange. Got some purple here. pumpkin has a little dent, so that's what I'm gonna do now. This. Okay. I have some light too. I'm gonna add some shadows here. Okay. A little bit more orange so it's not so dark. Okay, so pumpkin. Okay, and my oranges, I'm gonna use orange and yellow, so it's not the same color as my pumpkin. I'm gonna let these to dry and I'm gonna do my background. So I'm gonna do my background horizontally. I'm gonna do the landscape, not the portrait, the landscape position. Because I have lots of objects and I wanna be able to arrange them like this, horizontally. Okay, so let's start. It's gonna be really important to make sure I have a table, so I have some kind of ground to put my still life on. And then background, since these are all light, I'm gonna do a little bit darker background. So let's see how this is gonna look. I'm also going to mix the colors so it's not all solid color background. So this is my table. This is my flat surface. I'm gonna make the background, I'm gonna do dark green and then I'm gonna add some colors to it. Some light this background so it's not all dark green. And then what I'm gonna do and I'll do that at the end actually I'm gonna add some curtains on the side and see how's that gonna look. So this is my background. Okay. more like a landscape, I know. But this is going to be for my still life. So I'm going to go ahead and glue. Gonna glue the details because they're dry already. And at the end, I can decide if I want to add curtains or not. Okay, and water pitcher. I think it looks good here. Because I'm going to put fruit on this side. And if you want to add some little bit more color in your details later on, you can do that. Pumpkin. Apple. So I'm going to put them next to each other because they're all fruits. This is my still life, and I can play still with colors a little bit. I can add some details. I see that this bottle needs something more, but I'm going to be really careful because I don't want to get it to my background, okay? So I will add some color to it. As I said, I'm really careful because I don't want this to go in the background. So one side I'm doing, kind of putting some darker color, and the other side I'm going to add some white. I'm going to do this for all of the objects that I glue. I'm going to add some white on one side. You see? Just a little bit, tiny bit, just a little white on the tip of my brush, just like this. So this is in my still life, and I can still play with the background. And I can also add a little darker spot here under each object because these are the shadows, okay? So I'm gonna put some little bit of purple color, just like this, just a little tiny, just under, let's say this is a shadow. So I'm not going to add curtains in this one, but if you want to add your curtains, you can just paint them here. You need to use one solid color and maybe pick up something darker that can cover all this. But I'm going to leave this like this for now. You can play this with this as much as you want and add more color. And you can add more. We can definitely add more shadows here down. So now you can basically look and see what's missing, if you need to add more details on your object or some shadows or some light on the side. But make sure to put light on one side and the dark or on the other side, and add some shadow underneath. Okay, so that's our still life. I hope you enjoyed this project. I really did enjoy it myself, and I hope you're gonna have fun with it. I'll see you soon.